says, this is my last resort. Suffocation, no breathing. Don't give a fuck if I cut my arm bleeding. This is my last resort. Cut my life into pieces. I reach my last resort. Suffocation, no breathing. Don't give a fuck.
Hello YouTube viewers, today I'm going to be showing you how to solve this Rubik's magic. Now it's pretty much very simple. I'm going to be showing the advanced method and the beginner method. The advanced method is going to be more towards the end, so if you're learning the advanced method, skip to the end. The exact point will be in the description video, the video description. So let's start out. First, you want to make sure you have the three rings. That's how you have to start. So, I'll give you a second to try and figure out a way to get the three rings. You can always pause it. So what you want to do is, you want to take the right side and turn it in, and then take the left side and turn it in. Alright, and it should be folded up like this. And you take this bottom part and flip it. Okay. Now you want to pull it apart. Alright. And now you should have two half rings right here in the middle. And then on the bottom, half ring on the top. Now this is called a roll. A half roll. What you do is you fold it. Make sure you fold it this way, and right here, this little spot right here, you put your finger there, and only one panel is moving over, right? And then you flip it back. Now you should have a half ring, a full ring, half ring. Now you flip it over, and here you should have a whole ring, like 3/4 of a ring, and then a half ring. Okay? Should look something like that. Now you want to do this. Just follow what I do. Sorry, don't do that. Make sure when you're doing this part, you only take one and fold it up. It's supposed to look like this. Only take one. And then turn it over. And there you go. Now you have your three rings. If you have any questions, comment, please, and subscribe to me. Now to get it back, just go backwards. You go back, if I'm going too fast, you can always pause it, so flip it over. Here's the half rings. Then you want to accordion it in, so it looks like that, like a W. Close it. And then this top side is going to be facing you, and you want to take the two here, and then you want to pull it out, and there's your three rings again. Now for the advanced method. I suggest you know how to solve it first before you watch this segment of the video. So what you do is you take the two ends and bring them together, and it's gonna look like that, right? And they should be connecting, sort of. Now what you do is you take it, the top row, and you turn it like this, right, and flick out. Alright, so watch. I'll do that again. Flick out. Okay? Then you should have, like, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, and then here's just like less, almost nothing. Okay, so from here, you're gonna lift, it should be flat like this. You're gonna lift the bottom panel up, then take the right panel, turn it over, lift this panel up, and you should have this. Now, mine is broken, so when I turn it, it doesn't follow, so I have to push it up. But when you turn this pack with this panel back, this piece should be sticking up. Now turn it over, bring these two panels over, bring this one up, and here's your last step. Turn it over, and there's your three rings. Now let me give you an example of both. Here's the, here will be the beginner method that I will do first. And I'll show you why each one is beginner and advanced. Okay? Okay, I'm back to my three rings, and now I'm going to do the advanced method. It's going to look pretty weird since I'm doing it so fast, but it's just showing how fast you can do it. Ready? Done. Whoops, that piece slipped back. Done. Alright, so, thanks for watching my videos. If you have any questions, please comment on this video or my YouTube channel. And if you guys want me to be more specific about how to get the rings, or if you want me to make a video on the cool shapes that you can make, just message me, alright? See you later.